While cleaning my atelier, I found out this little wooden, artwork. It's not, doesn't look so special, but it's always a story around it. There was in the times I did volunteers work with mental handicapped persons. It's about 3 years ago. And the leader of it, he made this one. And it lay near the fire where we're sitting, talking. And he said, "Oh yeah, I wanted to throw it away. It's a symbol of the bear. It's a symbol of introspection, and I'm out of this now." And I said, "Yeah, I'm making it myself. I'm making a bear at home myself." But I wasn't not really into the symbolics. Now I understand that I'm in an introspection for 3 years, but actually I want to burn it too. Anyway, he gave this one to me and I gave mine one to him. And that's for me, that is has so much more symbolic than that. Much more value to say than I would have paid 300 euro for it. You know what I mean? And so the journey goes on. This one, special. It's handmade, by the way. It's all silk and hand-broidered in Japan. It's an antique kimono, by the way. I wanted to buy myself some, but the ones I found on the internet were all too expensive or just synthetic kitsch. So I found this one on a site, and I could buy it in Antwerp. And there's a little funny story around it again. The stories that make my life cool. I don't know, I always find the good words in English, sorry. But anyway, I went there and the man, he said, "Oh, my wife, she it was the 14 August and 15 August is the celebration of Mother Mary and Jesus. And at that particular day, of course, all the church, the big cathedral in Antwerp is painted, and the statues are very beautiful dressed. And that woman, she's the first woman in the whole entire history that is allowed to dress Jesus and Mary. And normally nobody was allowed to go into the closet, a big closet with the most beautiful broderies you can imagine. And for me, it was, you know, free entertainment and again coupled on this beautiful kimono. So again, a beautiful story. Like, yeah, these have it too. I was looking for them on internet, and the papa of Jesse, he came in. He said, "Mary, I was cleaning out that room and I found two skulls." I said, "What?" At the same moment, telepathy or what? So okay, cool, give it to me. This one, I put it outside and it got dirty, and then I painted the gold. I don't know if you see it. It's the horse energy. Yeah, let the horses free. That's logical, huh? And this one is actually the opposite. That is the skull of a bison or a cow. It's the fertility, tranquility, down to earth, as both energies here. I wanted to put all little turquoise in it, but I didn't found the right ones yet. So we're going to the next story. Black star, in some kind of way. It's in my mind for about 10 times a second. And I have a lot of questions around it, but in a very mysterious way, I'm not allowed to know it. I have to figure it out myself. That's what I want. I put it here on the net. Because if I write it private, it's not private. Nothing of me is private. So I'm thinking to go to the forest, deepest, darkest forest of North America, and go sitting there with the oldest natives, non-polluted, nothing cyber effects, pure, real to the core. And I want to sit with them in a sweat lodge until I know everything about this lady, by the way, because she's the Magdalene. She's painted by a good friend of mine. I met him at 7 o'clock in the morning in Rennes Le Chateau. Also a story, I was doing just a course, and that woman, oh yeah, I'm going to visit the Rennes Le Chateau, that's where Maria Magdalene lived. I said, oh my God, I'm into Maria Magdalene, that's cool. So we went there, and the first morning, we stood there at 7 in the morning, looking at the sun rise. And Maxime Remy stood there, an artist who made things like this. And we were lost out of paper. And we asked him, are you maybe, you know, somebody who has paper? Oh yeah, I have my gallery here in the center, come. And now it's actually his work. His work is like a medicine. It's very ethereal, it's angelical, it's kind of a little bit naive, childish, but that's now just the cute thing about it, and it works. If you're in a dark mood and you look at his paintings, it's, well, and then you have to see them in real. That is cool. Okay, next, what to say? Over there, we had a few years ago, and just, it is real. The pictures are, there are pictures, but they don't look that spectacular. That's why I don't show them. There was a big circle of about 8 meters. And the grass was 15 centimeters higher than the other grass. And it was darker. Then we had 2.5 meters and another 2.5 meters. And they were like a lemniscate, cut like a little bit in each other. But exactly round, also 15 centimeters higher than the normal grass. Okay. And we just erased it, and like 3 months later, it was still there. Now it's gone. But so for me, to me, that is an alien circle. You can tell it what you want. It's only, I want them just to arrive here and hold my hand, you know, because I see, it interests me. I see a lot of movies or programs of it. And then you hear people talking about, yeah, we see them in the dream world. They're in other dimensions. And for me, it's all possible, but they can live in this dimension also. Why there is no picture of it? Why? I want to shake a hand and have a picture of it. And not for myself. I'm not like, I can't find the word in English. I think if you can do that, and you have your ideas, you can change the world, because then the world will open their eyes. And then I speak about being ecological and being like the true revolution is the evolution of consciousness, something like that. And I also believe they have the techniques. They have the techniques to clean up the mess we made. Okay, next. Oh, in a funny way, I call myself, you are Maria Guevara, and why? Can somebody have an explanation of that? Because I'm in exile and I live in the fruit hills of Wallen. I don't live in the mountains of Cuba. I live in the fruit hills of Wallen. It's open, it's a beautiful alter ego, that's for sure. What we have here, that's my fashion show. This is my fashion show, yes. I had a burn in my house, you see, my house was almost gone. I had everything you can imagine I had in my life. And then there are people who are a bit surprised that you sometimes a bit not okay, but okay. I'm gonna cut this off because YouTube cannot contain more minutes, I think. So, bye bye.